What actually is the metaverse?
Our company is now
Lens. Facebook 正式更名为 Meta。
The idea of the metaverse is basically to create a world out of our imagination. You will believe it to be true, and you'll wish it was so because you'll be happier in the metaverse. The metaverse is made possible through a virtual device that allows your entire body, not just the physical headset, but your entire being, to be submerged into the world of the metaverse.
So, we're gonna have an astrophysicist in the family.
Actually, I have to write this paper. Will you help me?
Let's take a closer look.What part of the solar system are we talking about?
Saturn.
If you were taking astrophysics, you could study in the metaverse.
Did you know the rings are made up of billions of icy particles?
Really?
Look at this.
Hello, I'm Wade, your knowledge host. One of the biggest buzzwords towards the end of 2021 and the start of 2022 has to be the metaverse. Gaining tons of media coverage as well as daily news reports, but just what exactly is the metaverse? When we talk about the metaverse, other buzzwords come up, such as crypto and blockchain technology. This is due to the incorporation of the NFT, non-fungible tokens, being embedded into the metaverse by the promoters, with blockchain tech as the gatekeeper to this new and yet unexplored world. One source defines the metaverse as hypothesized iteration of the internet, supporting persistent online 3D virtual environment through conventional personal computing as well as virtual and augmented reality headsets. Okay, this still sounds pretty complicated. For example, what does hypothesized iteration, virtual environments, or augmented reality even mean? Well, simply put, it's like using a pair of 3D glasses to watch a 3D movie. But with the metaverse, it's a much more immersive experience. Take Second Life, for example. It's an online multimedia platform that allows people to create an avatar for themselves and have a second life in an online virtual world.
To us and people in the virtual world, we are exchanging real human interaction with each other. So yes, even though I was sitting in my room on the computer, you know, I was playing cards with my friends. That's the cool part about being in a virtual world while a pandemic is happening all around us.
The distinction between the VR and AR metaverse is that AR enhances both the virtual and real world, while VR only enhances a fictional reality.Controlling avatars in a VR metaverse is one of the ways for people to live in a virtual world. However, this is limited to the virtual space. Augmented reality, on the other hand, uses a real-life setting. Such a reality is portrayed in the movie Blade Runner 2049. Could you even imagine what living in that world would be like?
Voilà. Bon appétit.I missed you, baby sweet.
Coincidentally, or by design, we also have a sci-fi movie titled 2049, The Hedgehog Principle, produced by the manager of Greener Grass Culture, Phil Tang. In his interpretation, Life in the future, including one with the metaverse, wouldn't change the innate desire of human beings. Our needs are embedded deep within, and it's unlikely to change in the foreseeable future.
为什么放在就是想2049想说其实人类就是会有很多永远都
Why focus on the year 2049? Well, it's really to show that even in the future, there will be many things that for us as humans won't change. For example, will there be fortune tellers in 2049? We think so. There will always be people who want their fortunes told in order to know what the future holds.
So, for Phil Tang, the metaverse world is something he's immersed himself in to help come up with the concept and create his movie. In the same way,Cell phone giant HTC has created its VR world for more than 3 years now. They have two VR goggles called Vive Focus and Vive Flow. HTC Vive Original has a VR platform called Beat Day. Beat Day is a concert-themed metaverse.
In 2015, the virtual reality technology kicked off an entire ecosystem. In 2019, Cher said that Vive Reality focuses on the virtual world created by Vive as its core, which includes VR, AR, XR, blockchain, and AI.
Wang Xiaohong, Cher, is an expert at investing and creating the most expensive stocks in Taiwan.She led HTC to break into the metaverse industry 3 years ago. The market size of the metaverse industry in 2020 was less than $47.69 billion globally. However, market analyst firm Emergent Research projects the global metaverse market revenue will grow to $828.95 billion by 2028. We believe Taiwan will play a key role all the way through to the exploding future, with TSMC in chip making,HTC Vive Original in content creating, amongst other assets in leading the way.
In the development of VR, our vision of Vive Originals is to bring people more entertainment experiences with cultural value into the virtual world.Under such a vision, we make movies, animations, communities, fine arts, interactive arts, and cultural collections. You name it, we've tried it.
We, HTC, not only try to get our foot in the door of the metaverse, but we also developed some crucial techniques and equipment as means to enter the metaverse. It's sort of like a key for us. In addition to our research and developments, with the connection to all kinds of developers and all sorts of entertainment content,that allows us to confidently proclaim ourselves as bellwethers in this business. But sooner or later, every other industry will look to join this venture.
Moreover, we have online gaming platforms that's been developing for quite some time now. Future Game, 未来全球科技 might not be on your radar, but perhaps you've heard of the online gaming brand.Mingxing Sanquan Yi and Wei Wu Duzun. The founder of Future Game is also keeping an eye on the metaverse market. General Manager Cai Yiqing looks to a more dynamic cross-industrial application for the metaverse market.
For example, let's say I cooperate with a traditional Chinese medicine doctor.They could offer online purchasing and even online patient visits to determine whether or not they are the best suited doctor for you. Today, we can cooperate with Teacher Tang. If you need your constellation explained, you can collaborate through our platform. It's all possible.
Albert Einstein once said, "Imagination is more important than knowledge."Imagination is what propels human creativity. Imagination gave us the metaverse. And it will be that very same imagination that will take us to places beyond. Our human nature and desires, however, are likely to stay with us. As we see in the movie 2049 The Hedgehog Principle, with the burning of incense and saying a prayer. being traditions that people uphold. Yet, perhaps the way we go about it in the future may appear differently.
他拜拜的时候他不烧香，他就手机打开来，就往上一滑，就三支香在这。
He doesn't use an actual incense stick to say a prayer. Instead, he pulls out his cell phone, and with a single swipe, three incense sticks pop up. It's the little simple things like this that I'm fond of.Another example is, while I was writing this story, I wanted him to be eating oyster omelette. Even though it's 2049, oyster omelette is still a dish they crave. However, it's a robot preparing the dish.
Having an avatar robot serve you your favorite dish sounds like something that only happens in the movies. Yet at the same time, it doesn't seem far-fetched from the future we are currently building for ourselves. The reality is that in the year 2022,We are already looking to our digital wallets, with NFTs and different cryptocurrencies that will all play into the metaversal world. Lifetime professor at Chiao Tong University, Dr. Lin, said that traveling through the metaverse will be the same as traveling to any foreign country, like the States, for example. It will just be a new space for people to explore.
就像我们出国到美国去，对不对？你到美国看啊，很多新奇的东西。
It would be like us traveling to America and seeing many new things for the first time, wouldn't you agree? Now imagine yourself visiting the metaverse. It's a foreign place outside your daily environment with many interesting things for you to explore and discover. So I think if your motivation for entering the metaverse is to expand your imagination, and you're able to do so, bringing more comfort and meaning into your life, then by all means, do it.
American author Jack Canfield once said,Change is inevitable in life. You can either resist it and potentially get run over by it, or you could choose to cooperate with it, adapt to it, and learn how to benefit from it. When you embrace change, you will begin to see it as an opportunity for growth. An appropriate quote. As we look to an AR/VR future, the metaverse is here. Whether we are ready for it or not is up to us.
接下来我们请 Ruby 揭晓今天 Knowledge 的学习重点。Hey Ruby, do you know the difference between VR and AR?
Well, I know VR stands for virtual reality, virtual 虚拟的 reality 现实 Virtual reality 就是我们所说的虚拟实境咯
Exactly, like the movie Ready Player One. And what about AR?
Let me guess, animated reality?
Not quite. The A actually stands for augmented.
Augmented from augment, like augment one's income, 增加收入
Yep, 表示增大
增大现实是像放大镜吗
Well, more like 扩增实境
Oh, so like 结合虚拟与现实让实境扩增到虚拟中
Yeah, exactly. In VR, it's all virtual. But in AR
Reality and virtual 巧妙地结合在一起
Yes, like Free Guy.
What guy?
The guy in Free Guy.
You lost me.
The movie, Free Guy, they portrayed an AR world.
Oh, that guy.
Yep, and I can't wait to see what the future holds. Well, I'm Wade.
I'm Ruby.
I hope this episode of Knowledge was insightful and you learned some more English. Join us on the Fun Day website for more. Let's make every day a fun day.